Myself Nirdosh Kumar Rajput, and in this lecture we will discuss formation of quadratic equation. If we have the value of the roots of this quadratic equation, then how to do the formation of quadratic equation. If we have the value of alpha, beta, means if we have the value of roots of the equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then how to get the actual quadratic equation. Okay, fine. So if we have the value of alpha comma beta, then we can find out alpha plus beta and also alpha into beta. Okay, then we know that ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, it is the quadratic equation. It is the general form of the quadratic equation. Here a comma b comma c belonging to real number and a is not equal to 0. Okay, if we divide the a by a in the whole equation, then we get x square plus b by a x plus c by a equal to 0. Okay, then x square plus x square, if we take minus here and also, then we get minus b by a x plus c by a equal to 0. Minus minus equal to plus, then these two equations are same. Okay, so what is the value of this? What is the value of minus b by a? It is a alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. So then we get x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus, then what is the value of c by a? Then from the previous lecture we know that c by a equal to alpha into beta, then we get alpha into beta equal to 0. So if we have the value of roots of this quadratic equation, if we have the value of alpha comma beta of this quadratic equation, then we can find out the quadratic equation. So we have the value of alpha and beta, then we can find out alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. So we can form this quadratic equation x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta. So example, if we have alpha equal to minus 2 and alpha equal to minus 3, then we have to find out the quadratic equation. Then what is the quadratic equation? How to find out? X square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta equal to 0. Then x square, put the value of alpha and beta, then minus 2 minus 3 x plus minus 2 into minus 3 equal to 0. Then we get x square minus 5 into minus, then plus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. So if we have the value of alpha and beta, means beta equal to minus 2 minus 3. So we have the value of alpha and beta, means we have the value of the roots of the equation, then we can find out the quadratic equation. Okay, so let's solve the another example. So it is a problem. So first of all, read this problem. So problem is that given that the equation x square plus x plus 3 equal to 0 has roots alpha comma beta, then find a quadratic equation which roots are 1 upon 2 plus alpha comma 1 upon 2 alpha plus 3 comma 1 upon 2 beta plus 3. Okay, fine. So this equation has two roots which are alpha comma beta. So we know solution. So from this equation we know that alpha plus beta, what is alpha plus beta equal to? Minus b by a, where b equal to 1 and a equal to 1 and c equal to 3. So minus b by a, then minus 1 divided by 1 equal to minus 1. Similarly, alpha into beta equal to c by a, then from this equation we get 3. So we know these two values, alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. And we have to find out the equation which has the roots 1 upon 2 alpha plus 3 and 1 upon 2 beta plus 3. So how to find the equation? If we get the value of alpha plus beta, means we can say that it is the gamma, it is a delta. So if we get the value of gamma plus delta and gamma into delta, then by using the formula x square minus gamma plus delta x plus gamma into delta equal to 0, we get the quadratic equation which has the root gamma and delta, means 1 upon 2 alpha plus 3 comma 1 upon 2 beta plus 3. Okay, fine. So we have the value of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. Okay, fine. So first of all, find the summation of these two roots. So 1 upon 2 alpha plus 3, 2 alpha plus 3 plus 1 upon 2 beta plus 3. So we get the LCM, then 2 alpha plus 3 multiplied 2 beta plus 3, and from here we get 2 beta plus 3 plus 2 alpha plus 3. So from here we get 2 times alpha plus beta, 2 times alpha plus beta plus 6, divided by, if we multiply these two terms, then we get 4 alpha into beta plus 6 alpha plus 6 beta plus 9. So from here we get 2 alpha plus beta plus 6 divided by 4 alpha into beta plus 6 times alpha plus beta plus 9. And from here we have the value of alpha plus beta and also alpha into beta. Then we get the value of 1 upon 2 alpha plus 3 plus 1 upon 2 beta plus 3 equal to 2 times alpha plus beta equal to minus 1, then minus 2 plus 6 divided by 4 times alpha into beta, means 12 plus 6 into minus 1 plus 9, means here from we get 4 upon 50. Okay, then summation of these two roots, we get 4 by 15. Also we just require the value for finding the equation which are the roots of these two value, then we require 2 alpha plus 3 multiplication of 2 beta plus 3. So these two roots these are the two roots of equation to which we have to find out. So these are the multiplication of the roots. So we get 1 upon 4 alpha into beta plus 6 times alpha plus beta plus 9. So from here we put the value of alpha into beta and alpha plus beta, then we get 1 upon 50. So first of all, we assume it is a gamma, it is a delta, then we get gamma into delta equal to 1 upon 15, and gamma plus delta equal to 4 by 15. So we have to find, it is clear that, so we have to find out the equation which has the root gamma and delta. So equation is that 1 x square minus gamma plus delta into x plus gamma into delta equal to 0. Then x square minus, put the value of gamma plus delta, then it is the gamma, it is a delta, then gamma plus delta equal to 4 by 15, then we get minus 4 by 15 x plus, put the value of gamma into delta, then this is the gamma, this is the delta, then gamma into delta, we get 1 by 15, then this is the 1 by 15 equal to 0. If we do the solve this equation, then we get 15 x square minus 4 x plus 1 equal to 0. So this is the equation which has the root 1 upon 2 alpha plus 3 and 1 upon 2 beta plus 3. So this is the final answer of this problem. Thank you to everyone.